A lot of the world changed between season 4 and season 5, and the writers had to even look at characters that they created and things that they thought they had to kind of go back and look at. They've created this character, L.L. Moore, and he was sort of this sleazy old man who, like, hit on women. And
it was funny. It had, like, a funny element.
Yeah, it's not funny anymore.
Yeah,
it's not funny anymore.
For us to take it so lightly, I think they were like, oh, here's our opportunity. This is not light, you know? They're so wonderful. They're so great. And I feel like it meant so much to us and everyone who's going to watch. And of course, it's in a lighthearted way for our 30-minute show, but such an important matter to be a part of.
Yeah, and I think they approached it with, in one way or another, a sense of humor because that lives in our show. And in some way, it makes the messaging more digestible, you know?
Well, it was very organic, so it wasn't, which was nice because it went from season 4 to season 5. And so what I like is that they didn't use it as a political platform to be like trending or whatever. Right. It just really was organic. And it also made us as the actors and the writers kind of look at it and go like, oh, wow. Like it wasn't like they seized an opportunity. It just came really naturally.
But they've always done that. Our writers have always, it's always felt incredibly organic and very, very topical and present about what's going on in the world. And that's, it's an opportunity.
And between 3 and 4 and 4 and 5, the world changed so dramatically. Between 3 and 4 was the election, right? So seismic shift in the world. Seismic shift.
There was an election. I blacked out.
And then Me Too between 4 and 5. So.
Yeah, I love
that. What's next?
Yeah,
exactly. What's between 5 and 6?
What's gonna happen between 5 and 6, Scott?